Gary Cohen is the Associate Dean of the Robert H. Smith School of Business at the University of Maryland, and I asked him about China's changing role in global trade.
Globalization has totally reshaped trade, not just from the perspective of trade itself, but from really the quality of life for many people all over the world who can more easily afford products. Now, China joined the World Trade Organization back in 2001, and China was a very different place back then. So China was not a big consumer of goods. They were a producer of goods, and quite frankly, their specialty was producing low-cost, labor-intensive products. And that's really how China began that growth, predominantly happening in the southeastern portion of the country. But China's a very different place today as relates to trade, because China now competes in technology. And that's taken them to a whole new level. We have to remember that back when China first joined the World Trade Organization, they were very small when it comes to trade. But they're not the first country to industrialize, but they're the first country to industrialize and grow at such an aggressive and massive rate. So globalization has been a real gift for China.
Turning to free trade agreements, has global trade been impacted yet, or will it with NAFTA currently under review and basically the collapse of the TPP?
Well, the collapse of the TPP was another gift for China. The U.S. pulling out of the TPP, and of course there are 11 other countries involved in the TPP. They'd love for the United States to change their minds and come back in. I don't see that happening. For China, this was a great opportunity. It's an opportunity for them to continue to be a powerhouse in Asia. They, of course, have now come out since then with the RCEP. That's the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. And I think that was in response to TPP. But when we talk about these trade agreements, and particularly from the U.S. perspective, pulling out of these trade agreements, this is a wonderful opportunity for China.
Gary, has protectionism become a threat, and will protectionist countries be left behind?
Protectionism is not the answer. I know that viewers, this is what we've been seeing a lot of over the last couple years with Brexit, with President Trump being elected. But it's not really the best decision. The answer is working together to make sure that we all practice fair trade as opposed to either illegal trade or unfair trade. If it's fair trade and it promotes intense competition, that's healthy. It's good for consumers. It's really good for everyone. But if countries are practicing unfair trade, then that's what we need to address.